So we use arrays in the Udacity app, for instance, for like course enrollments, right? You'll have more than one, ideally, you'll have more than one course that you're taking, or you might be enrolled in a nano degree, and or a set of nano degrees. And so those are all stored as arrays when they come back. So I might say that you're in CS 101 and you're in an Android course, for instance. And both of those will show up as an array that I parse through. Arrays are useful just because you, when you have a, like for instance, a list of items translates very well to like a list view or something else. So generally those are stored in some type of array data structure. So I don't use primitive arrays, but I will use ArrayList, for instance, because a lot of the responses I receive are from the server, and I don't know the exact size of them. There's a case where maybe a student's only enrolled in one course, but they could be also enrolled in 100. So I need to be able to accommodate both cases. And so an ArrayList will allow it to grow or shrink based on the response I get from the server. So there's several list views. There's a lot of linear lists, horizontal lists. You see lists everywhere, pretty much in it. So if you think of your, again, to enrollments, enrollments is a list view. If you have a nano degree, there's a special nano degree view that's also a list view in that case. And so they're in several places. Also tracks, tracks within the app, if you're scrolling horizontally, that's a list view in itself as well. So recycling views are important because you want to try to use as little memory as possible. So you really only want to render the views that are on screen at any moment, and because the list could potentially be very large. And so as you're scrolling through, you're recycling the views to make sure you're only rendering what can fit on that screen. The way we structure data in the application is very much still based on the concepts that you go through in the class. So we do have the notion of there's a nano degree class, there's a lesson class, there's morsels, there's all these individual units that we model as Java objects within the application. A lot of times this is kind of, especially working with an API, many of those decisions were already made beforehand. So because you're consuming an API, it's already been modeled in a certain sense. You know what endpoints you're hitting, you know what the responses are, and those responses generally are grouped logically by some type of object.